The one Itachi popping off right now in the position game. Just barely doesn't beat Extra on the back line. Here comes Extra on the breakaway.
Oh,
and
wow.
It's in. That's goal number one.
Surprise, that one found its way all the way in. Yeah. He just goes up for a clean challenge, but he's got Stake so close to him. Stake was thinking that perhaps those challenges around that BDS net were going to pop into the
net. The second one beat open net. No, Extra rotated behind and gets the clear. Puts it on target as well. And Mark Bahe closes on it. Follow-up's going to be good. BDS on the breakaway. Two goals now.
The value here is marked by eight, pressuring Itachi. Itachi knows he needs to buy time because he's the last one back, but how quick Mark by 8 got there and didn't allow him to dribble that ball into the corner, stick that one off the wall and leave it for his teammate. That was great pressure by Mark by 8.
We're up by two and to make it three off the kickoff. BDS absolutely making the statement in game one.
Gotta watch this one. This is, yep, the classic. One goes for the corner boost and it just takes the nasty pop over the guy right behind your kickoff.
As Extra keeps it onto the wall to himself, he's got Stake in front of him. Can he put the brakes on him? He does just, the Stake is able to stall him just long enough to give Zamboy time to get back. Here's Monkey Moon, goal number four.
You want to know why BDS is winning this series so far? It's because they have been so good at working out of their own half. Like, I think Giants are actually playing pretty good. But you're not wrong, though, about what Vodafone Giants, you know, should be thinking about. Because if trying to go full ham, you know, like this, leaves it wide open down the middle, right?
Yeah.
Like, it's clearly not the approach that's going to be successful when BDS are this solid on defense, right? So you have to give ground at some point.
And if I could pinpoint maybe two adjustments. One, I do think you have to rotate a little bit more because of how strong the BDS transition game has been, as they're going to put in goal number six. And the second thing would be finding demolitions on offense. You have to break up BDS. Only there's a single demolition in this game. Those two things combined could even out the game a bit more.
Yeah, demo's classic, you know, one out in front of the ball, which is a lot more situationally dependent.
Passes, so we'll see
exactly.
if Giants can string one of those things together. There's Monkey Moon through the sky, puts
Monkey
him into the box, and Extra's not going to miss for goal number one.
What is this touch from Monkey Moon? I mean, of course, initially he's thinking score it, but the adjustment, because he realizes he's going to be late to rotate the car backwards and kick it off. They're like, wait, what?
Yeah. Marked by A through the sky. Is anyone going to get back in time? No, that's going to be goal number 10 in a row, uninterrupted from BDS, going back to their last series. Across three games.
Itachi feels backflipped it too. Whew, he would have made that if he didn't have the mechanical error.
The backflip was the moment it was over. Zamboy puts this in front of the box. Two players going to bite, and Monkey Moon's going to try. Itachi gets the block, but there's Extra.
Jeez,
to put in
man.
Goal number three, and they are stomping him right now.
I'm sitting here thinking this one's going to be tight because it tends to be pretty close when these two teams play, but that 80% is looking real good right
now. He won't be able to put it in. Stake now going to try and stance him up on the wall and gets the block. Now chasing it down himself to put it into the box. Here's Itachi for the first goal. They're finally on the board.
Got a very fortunate roll on this ball. Look at it come off of this challenge.
Oh,
Monkey
no.
Moon's thinking it's going to bounce or Stake is going to touch it, but it just caresses that.
Extra. Oh, Stake gets past him. 2v1. Stake goes and pounds out the goalie as Itachi's going to try and put it on target. They get the pump on Monkey Moon, and Itachi will do it. Well done. They bring it within one.
You wanted the demos wave? You got him. Stake was able to work himself out of basically the same situation when he was on defense. Able to worm through a couple of people and get that ball going back the other way.
Itachi could work with off of one. 2 seconds left through two. Stake put on his onto the backboard. This is going to have to be the shot of their lifetime, and no, Extra extends it into the orange. The alternate corner, Marquez plays it back the other side. Past one up against Zamway. Extra and Monkey Moon get it around them for goal number one.
Extra, watch his approach to this shot. He sees Stake lose the challenge. Zamway thinks here comes the pop to the top left. Extra sees the early jump, so just
Itachi versus Monkey Moon. He gets it out to Extra, but Itachi over the top of him, and now just one player left at the back. Can he win the 1v1 against Mark? Goes, puts the brakes on him and ties the game.
Itachi gives them a taste of their own medicine. This is basically the same thing that Extra just did. Gets it in the 1v1, marked by it, gets a little scared, has to respect that pop just in case Itachi goes into an air drill.
We had already seen three goals for BDS in game two. Extra demolished in the shot behind, and Itachi gets his mark over rotating, and Giants have the lead.
And again, it's all about placement here. Zamway just battling two people in the corner and the demo and all the way to the back post there. That's great defense.
And then a great clear from Giants sends it back the other way. The ball spinning Morton near the ceiling right now is marked by it. Shoots, and the bump's going to clear the way again. Tie game.
Yep, it's kind of that problem that the Giants have found themselves in a couple of times. It feels to me their approach, we were kind of wondering how they were going to adjust.
The side. We'll see what Monkey and Extra can do. Itachi, excellent touch pass. Now Zamway putting another pressure mark by him. They get the bump of the demo on him, and Giants take a win.
BDS took the big risk here. Extra was the only one that could have stopped that play in the midfield, so Itachi able to just beat that ball by him was so
impressive. Oh, double commit on defense. Itachi's going to try and close on this, but doesn't have the speed to move at it. Zamway with a bump, though, and it's good! Zamway took the shot and then went for the goalie to pave the way for the second.
And marked by eight and Extra, neither of them even get a piece of that. And Monkey Moon has to hit the brakes to dodge Zamway. I think that might be the only reason he doesn't go.
Massive chance in this series. And if they win here, they're tying it up.
Ooh.
Extra now on the outside. Ideas, though, the infield pass going to tie the game.
Extra coming at this one strong. I mean, he's not even sure if Monkey Moon's going to get that, but look at that touch. I mean, when your teammate puts it right there for you, how...
She's looking for the demolition. Monkey Moon going to just get up and pinch it off the crossbar. But the pressure is still on as Itachi sends it up for 90, and look at this pressure from the Giants.
This is the only place this can score. Monkey Moon, that's a great clear, but the Zamway, again, he's the guy that's making the quick reads, and it's been on defense, on offense. He tries to put the...
And he'll move on this ball himself. Extra wins another one. Stake. Ooh. Just sees this awkward bounce. Monkey Moon puts it on the backboard. Marked by 8. Up for it. Gets both goalies and drops the entire game.
Oh, you could feel the Giants kind of pause right here as that one went straight off the ceiling. And Stake was kind of looking at it like, I don't really have the boost. And that's the situation where it's so scary. You're caught in no
cross, but they might be long. Boost is a shot from Itachi. Monkey gets in the way. And now Extra. 3-1. Stake traps it in the corner. Bumps on the Zamway as well. Pass across the box and
in. No!
Oh, I can't believe the own goal.
Oh, talk about unlucky. Oh, it's just you're rotating back in. And that only happens because that touch, like, it's not good.
As we cross halftime, still scoreless in game 5.
Stake, and it's going to connect. Wow.
Well done on the infield pass. Quick work here. One touch and then two.
Oh.
The third one's the nail.
And Itachi did so good, you can see in that replay, kind of break check.
36 seconds left, Extra trying to set up his teammates, but not able to get enough of a handle on the ball. And there's an infield pass off the wall somehow. Again, Mark just believes in Monkey.
Yep, but look at Itachi. Itachi's believing Zamway's got that. He starts moving out of the goal line.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I'm glad we both agree that this feels much slower than the previous overtimes already. Much safer play. This one pinches.
Mind.
We're both wrong. All right, cool. A minute. Look at that. Extra puts it through him. BDS on match point going into game 6.
Well, that's what you said back early on in the series, right, Wave? Sometimes you just need the fluke.
Sometimes.
How about a pinch challenge that just pings off the opposition, goes right into the net? You'll take that. Wow. Those are those awkward situations, right? You get that high bouncer and you're stuck on the backboard there. And Itachi actually makes the transition work. So that goes all the way back to that clear I was just talking about. I mean, Zamway is able to support Stake's awkward touch. He knows it's a bad situation, and he knows that
that situation, like, oh, okay, they had a clear. The goal is the touch to happen, but no. Because of how straight that clear was, you know, we can talk about it maybe on the desk. Marked by 8, going to score us and tie the game.
Not a bad touch from Zamway, but it gets too far away from him, and it's that quick pinch out to the middle. I mean, you get tied up following the ball.
Head. Extra's got to get this one in net. The rest of the Giants have hung back.
Ooh.
But here's Mark and Extra to an open net.
Ooh.
They'll score, and they'll go to another grand final.
The same thing as game 6. They think they're going to get the read, and Itachi, trusting his teammate to make the touch, misses. Stake cannot win the fight. And almost